Good morning. Have God's people revolted and departed? We're looking at Jeremiah 5, verses 20 to 25 this morning. Declare this in the house of Jacob and proclaim it in Judah, saying, Hear this now, O foolish people, without understanding, who have eyes and see not, and who have ears and hear not. Do you not fear me, says the Lord? Will you not tremble at my presence, who have placed the sand as the bound of the sea, by a perpetual decree, that it cannot pass beyond it? And though its waves toss to and fro, yet they cannot prevail. Though they roar, yet they cannot pass over it. But this people has a defiant and rebellious heart. They have revolted and departed. They do not say in their heart, Let us now fear the Lord our God, who gives rain both the former and the latter in its season. He reserves for us the appointed weeks of the harvest. Your iniquities have turned these things away, and your sins have withheld good from you. So have God's people revolted and departed? Sort of seems that way. They have eyes to see, but they do not see. They have ears to hear, but they do not hear. They don't understand. They have no fear, no respect for God. I mean, he controls the very oceans, but they don't respect him or have any caution toward him. He's pretty powerful. It's like you tell your kid, look, respect the person who can take your drone away. You might find that's a good thing. So they have rebelled and left him. And we said they're not thinking of anything spiritual. So like the latter rain, critical for their harvest, critical for us as God's end time people. We need that latter rain to be spiritually completed and ready for the intense crises that are coming here at time's end, kind of critical for us. These people aren't paying any attention to that. So his prophet tells them that their sins have turned the latter rain away from them. Their sins have withheld good from them. But God is still working to save those who can be saved. If he didn't care, he wouldn't keep sending them messages through his prophets. You know, he would just let them go. But he's still working to save them. Now, some people complain about the harshness of the Old Testament God, but I don't think they've read this part of the scriptures very much. In fact, as we look at this part of the Bible, we find a very patient and persevering God. I mean, let's face it, most of us would have given up on these people a long time ago. God is still working for them. It is because of God's mercies that they're not consumed. And it's because of his mercies that you and I are not consumed. Even revolted and departed, he chases after them, hoping that they'll turn back to Jesus. Let's pray. Dear Father in heaven, help us to be faithful. Help us to have eyes to see and ears to hear. Help us to use the brain to understand. Help us to recognize the power of God and the depth of our spiritual need. We pray, Lord, that certainly that we will turn towards God, that the latter rain would not be withheld from us, Lord. Please, please hear our prayers and help your people. Whatever the cost, please help us. We need to receive the latter rain so that we can be fitted for the crises that are coming to the people of God at time's end. So help us, Lord. We look to you. Thank you for hearing our prayers, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. So yes, God's people have revolted and departed, but God is still working for them. He's trying to get them back. Have a wonderful day serving the Lord God of heaven and earth.